not gonna conform to your mindset or what you want me to be or what they want me to be. I'm gonna do what my father orders me to do.
I am Shandor Wayne Young Jr.
You gotta get it with confidence. You gotta look at people when you're talking to them. You can't be shy. That's a sign of weakness.
I am Shandor Wayne Young Jr.
Well, you gotta speak with authority as well. You need a little more bass in your voice.
Say what you're saying.
Confidence.
What's
up?
Right here.
Hi. How you doing? From the guy.
I am Shadow Wayne Young Jr.
All right, yeah, that's better. All
right. Good afternoon. My name is Richard. I'm Shadow. I'm just a green up. We're from Mississippi.
How come you don't have that good old Southern Mississippi accent?
Well, because I've been actually moving around the country for a while, so I kind of lost it.
I hear it.
I was trying not to bring it out. But yeah, from Mississippi, several different places, and I came in contact with this information after starting a spiritual journey, and Most High led me here.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Shane.
And he'll be on the talk show radio show as well.
The senior type, all right. As my son was practicing his manliness over there, junior. But we did travel in our conveyance up from Atlanta, Georgia. And I got stopped in South Carolina. So I didn't initially stop. I was, you know, looking around, making sure, okay, it's for me. I pulled over by a exit, you know, in case things, you know, get crazy. There's no need to tow my vehicle. I'm not in an unsafe spot. So, you know, I rolled down the window a little bit. He asked me if I have any ID. And I was like, yes, what's the nature of the stop, sir? He was like, oh, well, you know, you were speeding. Going over 100. I was like, really? He was like, yeah, you got any, you know, you don't have a driver's license. I was like, I do. So I opened up my wallet, started going through all my cards, showing it to him a little bit. You know, we got the light on, no license. I was like, ah, man, I don't have my license on me. I said, but I have my birth certificate in the trunk. He's like, nah, I don't want that. You have anything with your picture on it. So I gave him an expired debit card from back when I was in North Carolina. And he asked for my birthday, went away, came back, and he asked me to come hop the car. I guess he didn't want to talk to me in front of my son. So he's like, well, before we, you know, get started, you know, are you some kind of sovereign citizen or something? I take a step back. I'm like, I have absolutely no idea what you're talking about. He was like, you're not part of the Moorish community or, you know, Moore's Nation or, you know, Malcolm X.
So they got those people in a box already.
And I was like, I'm not, I was like, I know about Malcolm X from school. I was like, but I have no idea, you know, about those other things. He was like, let me ask you this. Are you a United States citizen? It's like, well, I am an American national. He's like, well, that answers my question. And starts scratching, you know. And when was the last time anyone gave out a written ticket, by the way? I was like, what in the world was going on? I was like, sir, what, how can I help you? What do you need? And then he asked me if I have any identifying marks or any anything that shows proof that I own a vehicle, because I don't have a traditional tag. So my tag is private, and in Borders, it says not for commercial use, no driver's license, no insurance required, you know? And by this time, he had a guy as backup to come on, younger dude. So he's, you know, snooping around my car, looking inside of it, checking my VIN number and all that. So I was like, well, you know, there was like a Mustang right next to me. And then he cuts me off. Now I know how the Mustangs go. I can tell the difference between the two and all this. I was like, so I can feel, okay, he doesn't want me to ask questions. He doesn't want me to say anything. I was like, okay. So I take a step back. He's like, all ideals do not match, and they are different. Don't make this any harder than what it needs to be, but I'm gonna need you to slow down, okay? And the guy's like, the new guy, he's like, hey, so where you going? I was like, oh, I'm heading to Philly, you know, going to a seminar. Oh, really, for what? 49 USC. And then something clicked with the senior officer. And he was like, what's that? You know, the young guy said, what's that? The senior officer was like, I got it. I'll get him straight. You know, I want us to leave here with a positive experience. You know, I'm tired, da da da. And he gives me a piece of paper that says warning on the top. He scratched out the race section that said black. I guess when I told him I was American National, he scratched that out. But he was just like, you know, I just need you to slow down. I was like, very, very well. You know, and I went on my way.
But they had some sort of charging instrument. You mentioned something like that, right?
They gave me a warning ticket. Oh, so they said that I had a warrant out for my arrest in Georgia. I was like, really? I was like, let me borrow your pen. What county is that in? He said, you know what? Don't worry about it. I'll write it down. And he wrote down Fayette County. So, you know, I'm thinking, okay, I'll go handle that when I get back. Appreciate it. And then went on my way. Yes, that is. So.
Yeah, usually they're.
I don't even know. Like now I don't get in any kind of trouble. Okay, I'm very cooperative. I know people. I pick up on, you know, emotions and spirits and things like that. I'm not into anything. I got children. I have something to live for. So this whole warrant thing, I'm not exactly sure what that's about, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to get paid for it. But I'm just, you know, just putting that out there. I don't do anything, you know, weird and outlandish or anything like that. I might climb up the side of a building or a couple trees, but, you know, I was calm, you know, the whole time. I made eye contact, you know, very, friendly and, you know, approachable. I wasn't trying to be, a smart aleck, I possibly could. I've been following Tom Zach for about a year and a half, going on 2 years. Before that, I was looking into it amongst others and with myself for about 6 months. So I know a lot about different things and I'm closing in on how I want to move. But I'm just saying that because they don't want any trouble with us, really. Especially if you intelligently, like, put out that you know exactly, you know, what you're doing. So they didn't have a license, they didn't have a registration, which means they could not force me to do business, and left me with, you know, a warning, and I was friendly about it. So, you know, creating harmony is the key, and, you know, knowing how to move.
Yeah, mind state is very important.